Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the impulse test which is performed on the single phase transformer. Previously we have studied various tests such as short circuit test, open circuit test, back to back test, etc. All these tests were conducted in order to determine the efficiency and overall performance of the transformer. But impulse test is conducted to check whether the transformer can withstand the sudden rise in voltage or the impulse voltage. So let us study this test in detail. Now any equipment or the electrical device which is manufactured, it is tested as per the routine test or type test. Now the testing is very important so that what is the overall performance of that particular equipment can be determined. Also testing helps the manufacturer to understand whether the device he has manufactured can withstand certain stresses when it will be actually connected in the power system. So impulse test is one such type of test. So basically in impulse test, the strength of the transformer insulation is checked. The insulation of the transformer is very important part. If the insulation gets damaged, there will be short circuit conditions in the transformer and transformer can also get damaged. So to check whether the insulation can withstand the dielectric stresses is very important. So this checking can be done by using the impulse test. So let us study in detail the impulse test. First of all, let us study the introduction. So lightning is a common phenomena in the transmission line because of their tall heights. Lightning is a common phenomena in case of transmission line because of their tall heights. So whenever there is a bad weather condition, the lightning can strike on the transmission line. Now this lightning has the voltage which is of very high magnitude, and when such heavy voltage is struck on the transmission line, certain components of the transmission line are tend to get damaged. So this lightning stroke on the line conductor can cause the impulse voltage. So impulse voltage is a sudden rise in voltage which is of the very high magnitude as compared to the rated voltage. So when the lightning is struck on the conductor, it gives rise to the impulse voltage. So the terminal equipments which are connected in the transmission line such as power transformer experience the lightning voltages. Again, during all kinds of online switching operations in the system, there will be switching impulses which occur in the network. So whenever the fault occurs, the circuit breaker will open, it will clear the fault, then after clearing the fault, again the circuit breaker will close. Same thing happens with the isolator, earthing switches. So there is continuously switching phenomena which goes on in the transmission line. So due to this, there is the switching surges which also cause the impulse voltages. So the magnitude of this switching impulse may be about 3.5 times the system voltage. So whenever the switching occurs, whatever voltage is rising because of the switching phenomena is of the very high magnitude, that is up to 3.5 times the rated voltage. So such amount of switching voltage can damage the equipment which are connected in the transmission lines. So we already know that insulation is the most important constituent of the transformer. So basically windings of the transformer are insulated from each other. Also, the insulation protects the transformer winding from the damage. But if the insulation itself fails, then any short circuit condition can cause the burning of the windings of the transformer, which will cause very huge damage to the equipment. So insulation protection is very important if we consider the transformer. Now, any weakness in the insulation may cause the failure of the transformer. Now, whenever certain fault occurs or whenever transformer gets overheated or overloaded, due to the rise in the current, the heat is generated. Now, this heat will give rise to the temperature. This temperature can damage the insulation. So, the insulation which is used in the transformer should be able to sustain this value of high temperature. So, any damage to the insulation will cause a huge damage to the transformer. So to ensure the effectiveness of the insulation system of the transformer, it must confirm the dielectric test. So certain dielectric stresses which are induced on the transformer insulation, while designing the insulation, it should be selected in such a way that the insulation should be able to withstand this dielectric test. So we have to first of all check whether the transformer insulation can withstand this test by conducting certain test. Now, but the power frequency test which is conducted on the transformer cannot be adequate to demonstrate the dielectric strength of the transformer. Therefore, as the power frequency test is not adequate, we have to conduct the impulse test on the transformer. So, impulse test will determine the ability of the transformer insulation, or it will check whether the insulation can sustain the dielectric stresses. So, this category of testing includes, first is lightning impulse test and second is switching impulse test. So, impulse test again includes two categories, that is lightning impulse test and switching impulse test. Now, let us study about the lightning impulse test. Now, as the name itself suggests, certain amount of high voltage which is nearly equal to the lightning can be induced on the transformer. Now, it is not possible to create such a high value of voltage. Hence, the waveform in which the lightning might struck can be imposed on the transformer and the performance of the transformer can be checked. Now, lightning impulse is purely a natural phenomena. Lightning which is caused is due to the natural phenomena. Therefore, it becomes very difficult to predict the actual wave shape of the lightning disturbances. Now, whenever the lightning is struck on the transmission line, being a purely natural phenomena, we cannot predict what might be the shape of the lightning wave that is struck. Now, from the data that is compiled by the natural lighting, now over the years, tremendous amount of natural lighting has taken place. So, this data is compiled and from this data, it may be concluded that the system disturbance due to natural lightning stroke can be represented by the basic wave shapes such as, first is full wave, second is chopped wave, and third is front of the wave. So, from whatever data is compiled over the years, it can be predicted that when the lightning is struck on the power system, then its wave shape can be of following three types, that is full wave, chopped wave or front of wave. Now, although the actual lightning impulse disturbance may not have the exactly these characteristic shapes, but by defining these waves, one can establish a minimum impulse dielectric strength of the transformer. Now, lightning being very unpredictable, we cannot exactly state that these three types might be the actual shape of the lightning wave. But by using this information, that is by considering that the lightning which struck on the transformer might have these three types of shapes, we can determine the dielectric stresses of the transformer. Now, if the lightning disturbance will travel certain distance along the transmission line, before it reaches the transformer, its wave shape may approach to the full wave. Now, we know that lightning travels with a certain speed. So, whenever the lightning is struck on the transmission line, when it travels up to the transformer, the time taken to the traveling, the wave shape can be converted into the full wave. If during traveling, the flashover occur at any instant of the transmission line, then after the peak value, the wave has been reached, the wave may become more form of chopped wave. So, if there is a phenomena of flashover which takes place at any instant on the transmission line, then the wave which was traveling towards the transformer, it was going to be converted into full wave. But due to the phenomena of flashover, this wave will be converted into chopped wave. Now, the next form is that if the lightning stroke directly hits the transformer terminals, then the impulse voltage which will rise will rapidly until the relief of the flashover. Now, at the instant of the flashover, the voltage suddenly collapses and may take the form of front of shape wave. So in this way, the three types of shape waves can be determined for the three different calamities. Now the effect of these waveforms on the transformer insulation may be different from each other. That is, full wave may have a different impact on the transformer insulation. Chopped wave may have the different impact on the transformer insulation. Similarly, front of the wave can have different impact on the transformer insulation. So depending upon the wave shape, the insulation transformer can get damaged. But whatever may be the shape of the wave, disturbance of the voltage wave will cause the insulation failure of the transformer. So it doesn't matter what is the shape of the wave, whether it is full wave, chopped wave or front of full wave. It will cause the damage to the insulation of the transformer. As a result, the lightning impulse test on the transformer is one of the most important types of the test, because by using the impulse test, we can check the performance of the transformer insulation. Now, next type is switching impulses. So the studies and observations have revealed that switching impulse may have front time for several hundreds of the microseconds, and this voltage may be periodically damped out. Now we have already seen that there are three types of wave shapes which the lightning phenomena may take. So out of these three, the switching impulse may have the front time kind of wave shape. Now what is the meaning of switching impulse? So whenever certain switching activity takes place in the transmission line, for example, opening of contacts of circuit breaker, then again reclosing of the contacts of circuit breaker, opening of the isolator. So all these activity are causing the switching impulses. So the magnitude of the switching impulse can be up to 3.5 times the rated voltage. So the switching impulse can be very harmful for the insulation of the transformer. Now if we consider the standard, that is IEC 60060, IEC stands for International Electrotechnical Commission. So this standard has adopted the test for switching impulse for the long wave having the front time of 250 microseconds and the half time of 2500 microseconds with certain tolerances. So the performance of the transformer can be determined by the switching impulse test, and how to conduct this switching impulse test is explained in detail in the standard, that is IEC 60060. Now the purpose of the impulse voltage is to secure that the transformer insulation will withstand the lightning over voltage which may occur in the service. So when the transformer is connected in the transmission line, then certain amount of lightning over voltage may always occur on the transformer. So the main aim of this test is to check whether the transformer insulation can withstand these high voltages. So in order to create the high value of this voltage, impulse generator is used. So impulse generator is basically based on the Mach circuit. The diagram is as shown in figure A. So if we see here, certain connections are made by using the resistors and capacitors. So the impulse capacitor having the rating of 750 nanofarad are charged in parallel through the charging resistor RC having the rating of 28 kilo ohm. So these are our impulse capacitors and these are the charging resistors. So the impulse capacitors are charged by using the charging resistors. Now the highest permissible charging voltage is 299 kV. Now when the charging voltage has reached the required value, that is up to 299 kV, the breakdown of the spark gap F1 is initiated by an external triggering pulse. Let us see this in the diagram. So this is the spark gap F1. So whenever the capacitor is charged up to its rated voltage, then the spark gap F1 is initiated. Now as a result of this, when the gap F1 will break down, the potential of the following stage, that is point B and C, will rise. Let us see this in the figure. So whenever this gap F1 is initiated, at that time the potential at the points B and C will rise to a very high value. Now as a result, the potential difference across the spark gap, that is F2, will also rise considerably, and the breakdown of F2 is initiated due to following conditions. First is, the series resistor, that is RS, is of very low ohmic value if we compare it with the discharging resistor RB, which is of the rating of 4 kilo ohm to 5 kilo ohm as compared to the discharging resistor RC. The series resistor RS is of low ohmic value as compared with the discharging resistor RB, which is of the rating of 4 kilo ohm and 5 kilo ohm, and the charging resistor RC. Now, as the value of the series resistor is very low as compared to the charging and discharging resistor, there will be the breakdown of the gap F2. Also, the low ohmic discharging of RA is separated from the circuit by using the auxiliary gap FA1. So, due to these two reasons, the gap F2 breaks down. Now, these sparse gaps are caused to break down in a particular sequence. Consequently, the capacitors which were initially charged will also get discharged in a sequence. Now, the high ohmic discharges of the resistor RB are dimensioned for the switching impulses, and the ohmic resistor RA for the lightning impulses. Let us see this in the figure. So, here the resistor RA is designed for the discharge through the lightning impulses, whereas the resistor RB is designed for the discharge through the switching impulses. Now, the resistor, that is RA, which are connected in parallel with the resistor RB, when the auxiliary spark gap will break down with the time delay of a few hundred nanoseconds. Now, this type of arrangement is necessary in order to secure the functioning of the generator. As both the resistors are connected in parallel, the functioning of generator is very appropriate. So, the wave shape and the peak value of the impulse voltage can be measured by means of an impulse analyzer system, which are connected to the voltage divider. Now, whatever value of voltage is required can be obtained by selecting the suitable number of resistors connected in stages and by adjusting their charging voltage. So, depending upon the value of resistor and their charging voltage, we will get the output of the impulse generator. Now, in order to obtain the necessary discharge energy, parallel or series parallel combination of the generator can be used. Now, in this case, some capacitors are connected in parallel during the discharge. Now, the required impulse shape is obtained by suitable selection of the series discharge resistor of the generator. So, everything depends upon the combination of the resistors that are connected, whether they are connected in series or they are connected in parallel, or the combination of series and parallel. So, depending upon what is the value of the required impulse voltage, the connections can be done. Now, let us see certain formulas. So, the front time can be obtained approximately from the following equation. So, for the value of R1 very greater than the R2 and CG greater than C, that is 15.1, TT is equal to RC 1 to 3. Similarly, the equation for the half time can be obtained as T is nearly equal to 0.7 RC. Now, if we consider in practice, the testing circuit is dimensioned according to the experience. Now, let us study the performance of the impulse test. So basically this test can be performed with the standard lightning impulses of the negative polarity. Now the front time, that is T1, and the half time, that is T2, are defined in accordance with the standard. So we have already seen that how to perform the impulse test is mentioned in the IEC 60060. So depending upon the standard specification, the times are defined. Now the standard lightning impulses are given by the equation. For front time, T1 is equal to 1 to 2 microseconds plus or minus 30%. 30% is the tolerance. Time to half wave is equal to T2, that is 50 microseconds, and it has the tolerance of 20% plus minus. So this is the impulse test graph. Now in practice, the impulse shape may deviate from the standard impulse testing when the low voltage windings of the high rated power and the windings of the high input capacitance are used. Now the impulse test, which is performed with the negative polarity, is used to avoid the erratic voltage flashovers in the external insulation and the test circuit. So to avoid the erratic flashover, we are using the negative polarity impulse voltages. Now most of the test objects require the waveform adjustments. Now the experience which is gained from the result of the test on the similar units or the eventual calculation can give guidance for selecting the components for the impulse test. Now the test sequence consists of one reference input, that is RW, at the 75% of the full load amplitude, followed by the specific number of voltage applications at the full amplitude, that is FW. So these are the certain procedures for performing the impulse test. Now the equipments which are used for voltage and current signal recording basically consist of, first is digital transient recorder, second is monitor, third is computer, then plotter. Again we have the printer. So the recordings at the level can be compared directly from the failure indication. So whatever recording we get at these instruments, we have to compare it directly with the indication of the failure. Now for the regulating transformer, one phase test with the on-load tap changer, which is set for the rated voltage, and other two phases at the tested in each of the extreme positions. So let us study the connections for the impulse test. So all the dielectrics test basically check the level of insulation for the given equipment. So the impulse generator is used to produce the specific voltage impulses of the wave 1.5 to 50 microseconds. One impulse of the reduced voltage between 50% to 75% of the full load test voltage, and subsequent three impulses at the full voltage are provided to the equipment to be tested. Now if you consider the three-phase transformer, then the impulse test is carried out in all the three phases in the repetitive successions. Now the voltage which is applied on each of the line terminal in succession is kept to the other terminals earth. The current and voltage wave are recorded on the oscilloscope, and any distortion in the wave shape is the criteria for the failure. So whatever the current and voltage wave is received on the oscilloscope, they are recorded, and if there is a distortion in the wave, then it is an indication that there is a failure in the transformer insulation. So this is the diagram for the connection. So this is our transformer which is under the test. These are the HV winding, these are the LV winding. Then here the impulse test is provided. Whatever current and voltage wave shapes are obtained are checked by the oscilloscope. So this is the basic connection for which the transformer is tested by the impulse voltage test. The impulse which is provided to the windings of the transformer is generated by the impulse generator. So in this way, by providing the various types of impulse voltages, we can check the insulation of the transformer. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and do subscribe our channel eKida. Thank you.